and welcome to The Quest on Rajya Sabha TV. I'm Rakhi Bakshi. As you know that each week we bring you new personalities, they're leading ones, they share their views and vision on this show. And what an interesting journey it has been to talking to all these people all this while. And I'm sure you've also enjoyed the show as much as I have shooting this. Tonight we have a very special guest with us on Rajya Sabha TV. To describe him is a little difficult because he's somebody who represents ordinary characters on cinema, but is an extraordinary man. He's a filmmaker, he's a veteran actor, and now, of course, he's the chairman of Oscar jury in India. And we welcome him on the show. Welcome, Mr. Amol Palekar.
Thank you so much.
Is it a great burden or responsibility choosing one of the best cinema now that you're heading the jury of Oscars in India?
I feel terribly embarrassed. Embarrassed with the kind of reactions that we are generating, we as a nation. It almost looks like I have already won an Oscar and come back. That's not my job. My job, I am a chairman of a panel. We are 17 member panel, and which is going to select one film which will be the official Indian entry for the Oscars. That's all. Why are we going over the top? And we have, I mean, the whole hype that is created around this is something which makes me embarrassed and nervous.
Why do you think it's happening? I mean, do you think we have been craving for actually to be there?
No, I think it is more to do with today's times, where everything we have to create into an event, everything has to be a breaking news, everything we have somehow managed to raise the pitch to such an extent that unless we start screaming from the 17th floor, I think we won't be heard.
Someone would say maybe restlessness is correct because we've not been there, let's say, when we're talking about the world stage.
I don't think so. This is a hype which is created by Hollywood. To them, Oscar is something great. I have never looked at Oscars as something out of this world. It is one of the international forums which projects world cinema. That's all. To me, in fact, I have been saying this repeatedly, and I'll say it again today. To me, the national awards are the most important thing to me as a filmmaker, and as an Indian audience, I think that should be the real high point. But we have never looked at it. Even the media, the announcement of the national award, best film made in India today, appears somewhere on page 5.
True.
But never on the front page. Why?
Yeah.
Why? Why are we ourselves devaluing our own work and looking somewhere else? But this is...
That's a very valid point you're making. You've been a sensitive actor and filmmaker, and that's why you're there actually, to look at this range of cinema so sensitively. But the whole problem and the challenge is also to create the right balance. We are talking about a creative medium, which is cinema. We are also talking about the kind of commercial aspect it has.
Commercial aspect of it is box office. That has nothing to do with excellence in cinema. Any award is probably trying to see excellence in cinema, not at the commercial aspect of it. The commercial success, as we today call a 300 crore club and 400 crore club, and all, that's a different yardstick of a success. Yes, we are very happy and proud about it, but why are we mixing up these two things?
Exactly. So what would you really call good cinema with your own understanding and assessment?
A good cinema is something which tries to explore some new way of expressing cinematically what you want to say, whatever you want to say. And it need not be just a boy meets a girl story. When we talk of commercial success, we are necessarily talking of boy meets a girl, hashed and rehashed all over again for centuries. And then now today with item numbers put in, etc., etc. And yes, there is one major progress, I must say, that yes, even technical excellence has all the glamour and glitter that can be added to that has been added, but we are not looking, or we are not trying to look at the commercial experience.
Are you feeling that rush? I mean, there are films already, and I of course was reading and the reports that how some of the movies are being talked about, how some of the filmmakers must be very eager to be seen there. Do you feel that rush now that you're watching a lot of movies?
No. I don't think. See, as far as I'm concerned, I'm very clear what is my job as a person to select. That is my job. And it is not only me who's going to do that. There are 16 other members, and who have been part and parcel of film industry, having done their whatever bit all of us have done. So it is going to be a collective wisdom, and we are going to select one film which will start the whole process. Why are we jumping the gun and we are already creating this kind of mahol? I fail to understand.
But you know, generally talking about cinema, in this whole hype of some of the names which really come up, we read about and we watch, and there are all these machineries to, let's say, promote, we sometimes miss one of that cinema which is somewhere lost in the whole milieu, so to say. Smaller films, maybe films which are made on very important subject in some of the regions, let's say talk about Northeast. How would you look at it?
I like the way you put it. In fact, India is probably the only country which dishes out so much of a widespread menu, so
yeah,
to say.
Yeah.
You know, we have mainstream cinema with all its masala and glamour and glitter. We have mainstream cinema in regional languages. I mean, just to give you the example of Bahubali today.
Yeah,
it's
a
Telugu film, so nobody wanted to talk about it. Bollywood didn't want to take cognizance of that, as Bollywood never likes to take cognizance. But you can't wish it away. The success of Bahubali, the commercial success of Bahubali, you can't wish it away.
And the power of that medium.
Yes. So we have that in our country. We also have, as you very rightly said, very small cinema, regionals made maybe in Odia.
Exactly.
Maybe made in Malayalam.
You know, one of those movies we grew up watching on DD, Doordarshan, and I think you're also very fond of that kind of platform, as you've talked about in one of the interviews.
Yes. So all this cinema, very sensitive cinema, low budget cinema, and yet very powerful cinema, is being made in our country and being made very well, very beautifully, that all of us must not only take notice of, but we must be proud of it, that yes, this is our Indian cinema.
Sure.
And my effort is going to be to find such one cinema, one film, because we have to select only one film which all of us will feel proud that yes, this is what we are sending as a representative of Indian cinema.
Look at the kind of movies where we began: Mother India, Salaam Bombay, Lagaan, and further, of course, some accolades which came with, let's say, Bhanu Athaiya, and later, of course, with Slumdog Millionaire. How would you really look at this whole journey, this whole process of trying to really churn out something good and meaningful?
No, there are again, you see, having selected a film and sent for this one category, we are not competing in the Oscars. Yes, this is one category that we are trying to compete in. Now, in that one category, you have to select a film which you think is best Indian representation, A, and which can be some new expression, a different way of exploring cinematic idiom, which the world feels, oh wow, this is something nice. Now, why I'm saying this is exactly how Iranian cinema.
Very, very, very well said. Yeah.
This is how it came. It has no glamour, no glitter, no. Yes, but it captured the imagination, and everybody said, oh my God, what film? So this is how it came. films, I mean, you talked of Lagan. Lagan lost to a film which everybody said, oh my God. So we are, what are we trying to look at? If we are muddled and confused in our own minds, we only keep, we keep showing our muscles and all that, but we are not trying to realize how are you going to catch the attention.
But you talked about the right kind of lobbying, and when you say that, you also say that going by the rules, of course, yes, but trying to push the right thing.
Yes, we, I'm really sorry to say this, and I have seen it from close quarters. We don't do anything which is right there, and we only keep either criticizing ourselves ke are humne achhi film bheji thi uska kuch hua nahi. What kuch hua nahi, because you have not done anything right. You have not tried, you have not lobbied, you have not gone there, you have not followed the system, you have not followed the rules. I want to say this again. I know of a film where once it was selected as the Indian official entry, they didn't have money. And they gave a statement that we don't have money to promote the film, etc., etc. So people, I have seen those actors and filmmakers going on the streets of Mumbai and Pune and other from Maharashtra, it was a Marathi film. And people gave money with love, affection, pride, and they collected a hell of a lot of money to promote the film. Yes, they went with that good, whatever money they had, they went there. And they screened the film to whom? Only to Marathi mandals in America, who have nothing to do with the voting, who have nothing to do with Oscars. And they seeing the film there, clapping, applauding, and saying, yes, this is the... How does it help your cause? And then we here, sitting here, not being aware of all this, we also say, ki, yes, yaar, why don't we win an award? Why don't
very,
we win an Oscar?
I think very pertinent point you're making. We'll have to take a very short break out here, but we'll continue the conversation with you on so many issues that we really have to talk about. You are watching The Quest here on Rajya Sabha TV, and we are talking to Mr. Amol Palekar. Don't go away. It's a very interesting conversation going on. Many much more that you'll learn and you'll hear from this show. Welcome back to the show. You're watching The Quest here on Rajya Sabha TV. We are constantly talking to Mr. Amol Palekar. So the kind of cinema which is coming on to the scene also, how happy, satisfied or dissatisfied do you feel?
Oh, the kind of cinema that we are making today is really good. I cannot say that we are not making good cinema. Particularly small cinema, even in Bollywood, the kind of cinema that is being made, a little worry or unhappiness, let me put it that way, my unhappiness is with the number, not with the quality. I want that kind of cinema which existed during my time, which was called parallel cinema, experimental cinema, whatever.
Art cinema,
whatever label you want to give. But that cinema was on the rise. And it was a great commercial success also. I mean, nobody had a quarrel. And it coexisted with the masala film, with Amar Akbar Anthony, existed Golmaal.
Yeah.
So, I mean, this is what the scenario...
Even when you're talking about it, we are feeling happy. And I would really like you to talk about that kind of period. And how would you look at it?
So, yeah. You see, we had that period where all kind of cinema coexisted happily on Indian scenario. So where is the problem? And why is the problem that why do we keep insisting that we only have the one kind of cinema, because that's what the audiences want. This is what we are repeatedly told, that no, audience wants only this. Audience want entertainment, and entertainment without any kind of...
I think we're blaming them too much.
Unnecessarily, we are shoving our responsibilities on them. We are saying that they are not wanting it. No, we are not giving them. Whenever we have given them good cinema,
very true,
different cinema.
And I totally individually agree with that.
And I mean, I can rattle up at least 10 names in recent times, which is small cinema, sensible cinema, sensitive cinema, and in some kind of, you know, little different than the masala, glamour, glitter, item numbers, etc.
Also, do you think that whole line between being an actor and now being a star is being like, you know, blurred? I mean, for example, you've been such a great actor and talking about Rajinikanth or Golmaal or Choti Si Baat, people went and they saw and they really felt so nice.
And that cinema also was commercially successful.
Yeah.
And just to remind, which that kind of cinema unfortunately doesn't exist today in Bollywood, there was what we all were told to look down upon, and therefore it was called C-grade cinema. Was a cinema of Dara Singh and Mumtaz, and it was hugely popular.
So look at the standard, that's what
yes,
you're
so and all coexisted. My point is that it can coexist. Why are we trying to weed out and push this other cinema into dustbins? That is something
we are talking about art here, and of course something which is very relevant. I would like to ask you this whole FTII controversy also, and of course you've talked about art really being respected. How would you really say anything more on that?
What do you want me to say?
I mean, because you said that people who head such institutions of caliber and talent and creative platforms should have that kind of sensitivity also to head it.
Yes, I mean I have always looked at this issue with, again, sadness. Sadness because, you see, government, every government and any government is its prerogative to choose a person, their team, to head such institutions. Nobody is questioning that. I am not questioning that. Nobody is questioning that right. But just because you have the right, are you going to send an inferior kind of a person who doesn't have credentials, a person who inspires nobody? Then why are you shoving that kind of a person just because it is your prerogative, is my first question. My second question is, if government also agrees that, yes, he's not the best choice, that's what has been said by Mr. Jaitley.
Yeah.
That's, we agree that he is not the best choice. Then if you agree, then give us a better choice. I am not saying that give us the best possible choice, but at least give us a better choice. That is number two. And the second sentence of Mr. Jaitley's, what he said was more hurting, that, but as government we can't retract. Why not?
Because you have the power.
No, but because you have the power, you should also have the magnanimity to say that, yes, we made a mistake and we respect your view and we backtrack. We go two steps back and say, okay, let's find a better person. Let's find a better candidate who you also will be happy with, and we will be happy to say that, yes, this is what we want.
Another thing which comes up...
This is one side of it. I also would say that equally, the students also must not be so adamant and so to say that no, person with this color and that color is not acceptable. No, that is not what you should say, that is he going to inspire me? I mean, just if we look backwards, when
the broader framework.
Yes, when Girish Karnad was appointed, did anyone ask or did anyone ever think that which political party he belongs to? No, because his credentials as a filmmaker,
I think, were very
good,
valid point to make.
Were good and very inspiring. When Mrinal Sen was selected, yes, everybody knew he is from a left, staunch leftist. Nobody questioned that. When Ritwik Ghatak was there, nobody questioned that. So it is the credentials. And beyond credentials, a quality to inspire and quality which the students will feel that, yes, I can learn something and I can I can follow in his footsteps.
I think you've explained it very well. Another thing which comes up in talking about good cinema, and some of the filmmakers would argue that why we can't do it is because there are all kinds of burdens of censorship. Sometimes we want to creatively express something and certain things are kind of hampered because of that. How would you really look at this whole idea of taking the creativity ahead within, let's say, a very strict framework? Does that become limiting?
No, but what framework? Yes. Strict, when you say strict framework, then you have to lay down the rules, what is strict according to you, and what becomes an unnecessary constraint. It is for us to sit down and specify the framework. Nobody denies censorship. Yes, in principle I am against censorship. As far as films are concerned, I have always believed that unfortunately, the censorship affects good films much more than the vulgar bad films. Basically, censorship is against sex and violence. See, 80% of our masala films, they are abundance of sex and violence.
And they still go on and on.
They go on. There is no cut given, no nothing. And audiences have also learned to filter through that and accept it. So where is the censorship against sex and violence?
So we have to look at it.
So what is the censorship against? It is against a thought which probably disturbs you, a question mark which says that, oh my God, he is questioning my sensibility, my morality, so that's where the censorship comes in. And which I think is unfair and unnecessary way of curbing creativity.
Sure, very well said. You are of course talking about you also, acting, and now I think television is what you've chosen. So are you looking forward to some being in front of the camera and are excited about it?
I have been a reluctant actor all throughout my career. I mean, I used to reject 9 films out of 10 which were offered to me. So I was also known, and therefore, not only as a reluctant actor, but also a very difficult actor. I have no complaints about that. I have enjoyed that, and I am very happy that that's how I worked in the industry. It continues even today. At least 3 to 4 offers come my way in a month, and I keep on rejecting them. I have stopped seeing our television long back. I see television only
for Kachi Dhruv and all when we join.
Yes, yes. You know, and again, I'm sorry to say, but I feel really sad that Doordarshan has also deviated from what it used to do and what it did brilliantly. Today, instead of trying to compete with all these private channels, if Doordarshan just sticks to its
own core
and way of doing things, they still have the power. They are the maximum reach. Doordarshan used to show us regional cinema.
Yeah, true. I remember having watched them. Yeah.
Good regional cinema, not only show, Doordarshan has produced some of the best films in our country. Why have we stopped doing that?
I'm sure they're listening, the right people.
I hope they are listening.
Two things. Now, you're a painter also. Not many know, I think, but they should actually. And that's how you started, and extremely good at that. Talk about that, and also Paryavaran, which is also very close to your heart. So talk about these things.
Yes, I'm happy now for last 2 years. I have gone back to my first love, and I am very happy being a painter and nothing more and nothing less. That's where I started my creative journey, along with my theater activity and also films. I was fortunate, most fortunate I must say, that I could start dabbling into all these three areas simultaneously.
Again,
those were the times which gave possibilities of doing all these things. Those were the times, the Renaissance period as we look at it today and call back very fondly. Those were the times when interaction between different art disciplines, different creative fields was rule of the day. When painters would meet filmmakers, singers would sit down and do some experiments with visual arts, was not something very different and new or forbidden. I think this CMS Vatavaran, they are doing it for so many years and so beautifully. Now again, this is something which all of us should try and not only support, but build it up into a movement. Because yes, Paryavaran, isn't it our problem? It's not some individual's problem, or it's not for some NGO or somebody to take up the issue and keep on fighting. It is our problem. And if we don't think that it is our problem, then I think we are completely lost and on a wrong track. And therefore, this whole festival, trying to do wildlife conservation, trying to do other conservation, all, I mean, the kind of categories which
that's the kind of support cinema should have, actually.
Not only that, there is one more very important point, that it also opens up all the other avenues of filmmaking. When we talk of filmmaking, we always keep talking only of feature films. There are short films, there are documentaries, there are so many other ways of expressing your thing and sharing your thoughts with the audiences. All that also has gone into background, and that also is a chance here.
I know.
So I'm very
happy.
I think
I really feel that we should go on. So much is there, and I'm also very passionate about cinema, and it's a privilege to talk to you also. But I think we'll have to really end it right here. Before I actually wrap up, I want to ask you, my program is called The Quest. So what's your quest, Mr. Amolpalekar?
Oh, in fact, one of the last films which I had made was also titled Quest.
Yeah.
And it talked about gay and lesbian relationships on the backdrop of man-woman relationship. So my quest is to do something which is unexplored, which is forbidden maybe, which is considered not done, or which is not mainstream masala. My quest has been to try out some little different path, try and explore that and see if we can get happiness and satisfaction out of that.
So we'll have to end it up all here, but thanks a lot and all the very best for you're heading the jury right now for Oscars, but I think we really wish you all the best that you look at good cinema and promote it. Thank you so much for talking to us here on Raj Sabha TV, and that was a very, very interesting conversation we had here on The Quest on Raj Sabha TV. I'm sure you really, really enjoyed watching Mr. Amolpalekar as much as I did talking to him. Thank you so much for watching this particular edition of The Quest. Namaskar and bye-bye.